Hi everyone, I'm really excited to present this data on behalf of my co-investigators of targeting IL-13 with tralokinumab that normalizes type 2 inflammation in atopic dermatitis, both early and at 2 years. So the background for the study, tralokinumab that is known to all of us is now approved for atopic dermatitis in Europe, United States. For both adults and adolescents, it's an anti-IL-13 monoclonal antibody. And in this study, we are focusing on the biomarker changes in skin and blood that up to this study have not been previously studied after tralokinumab treatment in patients with moderate to severe AD. So the aim of this study was to evaluate both early and the two-year impact. So this is the first time that a very long-term study for 2 years with biomarkers is provided with tralokinumab treatment on both skin and serum biomarkers in adults with moderate to severe AD. And for this study, we had both skin biopsies and serum evaluated from a subset of patients enrolled in the phase 3 study, which is also a novel to have it not early in an early study, but in a later study. And we performed here gene expression studies and also protein expression studies as well. And we know that in atopic dermatitis, we have this lichenification of the epidermis with inflammation of type 2 pathway and also other immune pathways that we are trying to reverse with treatment. So let's see, first of all, in blood, we found that multiple immune cytokines that are important in atopic dermatitis, such as CCL17, a very important chemokine, TARC, is already by week 4 significantly modulated as compared to placebo, and then more at week 8 and continues to improve towards week 16. The same with periostin, that's another type 2 important biomarker, and also IgE goes significantly down continuously towards week 16, and IL-22 also goes down. IL-22 is derived from Th22 and is significant at week 16. In terms of the epidermal pathology, we see the epidermal thickness is normalizing, and also multiple measures that relate to epidermal thickness, such as keratin 16, Ki-67, and S100A7 intensity also are changing. And also loricrin is increasing, and also CD11C positive cells that mark dendritic cells are going down as well with treatment. Now, what happens to the inflammation in atopic dermatitis? So we studied it via RNA-seq, gene expression, and here you see tralokinumab and placebo. Let's start with the heat map. So we see non-lesional at baseline, lesional at baseline, and then week 16, and 2 years, both lesional and non-lesional. So you see that gradual red to blue transition only in tralokinumab. You don't see that in placebo. And of course, placebo, we only had up to week 16 because after that patients were put on drug. But with tralokinumab, we had all the way up to 2 years of time. And when you look and quantify that improvement in tralokinumab, you see a gradual improvement with drug. At week 16, 40% or 39%, and then 85% at 2 years, whereas at week 16, the placebo gets worse. So this is why it's so important to do biomarkers, because they tell you the truth. You know how the placebo always looks very high in atopic dermatitis? Because all the investigators wish for improvement, the patient is wishing for improvement as well, and you always get those high clinical scores, because this is subjective, but biomarkers are objective. Pay attention, 15% exacerbation in placebo. That's why it's so important to perform biomarkers. And when you look at the inflammation, it's really dampened. Th2 markers that are dampened, IL-4 receptor, IL-13, CCL17, even Th1, and likely this is a secondary effect, is dampened. Interferon gamma, CXCL9, and others. The Th17, Th22 pathway, such as S100A7, 8, and 9, also dampened. And the same with the IL-22 pathway that is dampened, and barrier genes are upregulated at 2 years, such as the epidermal differentiation and cornified envelope genes such as claudin-1 and loricrin. So you really reverse that pathologic AD phenotype, and it takes sometimes time. That's why between week 16 to week to the 2 year mark, you still have some improvement. So to conclude here, tralokinumab significantly normalizes the molecular phenotype of AD in skin and blood, and this data support the central role that IL-13 has in the pathobiology of atopic dermatitis, and I'm very excited to be presenting this to you. Thank you so much for your attention.